Hello everybody and welcome back to Metroid Prime Trilogy. I am Asa of the Sand.
Is this NPR now?
And that is Blackabells.
This is exactly what it sounds like, welcome, except we're not like on top
welcome
of
to Metroid and the NPR, Metroid Prime Radio. I am your host, and my special guest is playing as Samus, the intergalactic bounty hunter.
We just woke up. I woke up an hour and a half ago, but apparently he woke up half an hour ago.
Your excitement woke me up.
Yay! Oh god, I hate this.
Oh, the big pirate fight here?
Yes.
It's not bad, though.
I forgot about it.
Yeah, the first run through is not actually that bad, because they don't have the jetpacks.
You're right, this isn't the one I thought it was. Also, so, with the pirates, the model changes very, very drastically. In Prime 1, they have really big shoulders, and I know that's part of the, like, the suit that they're wearing, right? But also, they're a lot shorter, I want to say, in this one. They're about Samus's height. And in Metroid Prime 2 and 3, they're... I mean, you don't really encounter them much?
2, you encounter them a lot.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. I haven't made it very far.
Well, the first, like, half of normal Argon is pirates.
Okay. Alright, well...
Pirates and their experiments.
I know that in Prime 3, they're taller, but they're more hunched over, and also they're a lot more red, a lot less black, a lot more red and orange. There's also a lot more different kinds of them. Like, when I say a lot more different kinds, I mean, like, I'm pretty sure a quarter of the logbook for creatures is dedicated just to pirates.
In 3?
Yeah. Prime 3.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
Considering you go to their home world.
Yeah.
That, spoiler alert. What? I didn't say anything.
Yep.
I never say anything. Is that box indestructible or something?
That's an explosive box. It's supposed to blow up. What is this?
This is Sparta. Blow up the box. Yeah, box is under it.
Yeah.
Oh, you need... thermal.
Aww.
Or not thermal. Plasma.
That wasn't in the original.
Yeah, I imagine they don't want you to get
the artifact there.
Yeah, not yet at least.
I was so proud of myself for remembering that was there. And then the game didn't want me to get it.
Yeah, that happens a lot in this one.
And you can't even get plasma beam until we have power bomb, which that's way longer than it.
Yeah. That's very true. Very true.
Normally you can get it before power bomb.
That's true. Normally.
Well, not quite, but you're not supposed to be able to get it.
But you can.
Well, you get grapple beam.
Hey, look, a Metroid!
Yeah.
Yay! First one we're encountering in this specific playthrough.
Yeah, but for plasma beam, you're supposed to have ice beam,
yeah,
grapple beam,
yeah,
spider ball,
mm-hmm,
and...
power bomb?
Boost ball.
Okay. Also, I'd like to point out that the Metroid, they actually updated the Metroid skin and texture in the trilogy.
Really?
If you get really close to it.
I'm close.
Look, did you see? Because, like, they added more shine to the claws, and they made the,
It does look more shiny.
Yeah, the inside, the three little ball things, the nuclei, they're all like, they're a lot, like, they're more detailed. They updated the Metroid a bit for Trilogy.
Is the trigger gonna happen if I turn around?
No.
Then,
You have to break it.
Oh, in, Prime... non-trilogy variant.
Yeah, you didn't have to break it.
Yeah.
Holy shit!
We have so many missiles.
I didn't expect that. I imagine you could have busted through there and it would have broken out and attacked the pirate or something.
No, I think the pirate won't break through there unless you,
I know, I'm saying, I imagine if you... You could have broken that wall, I imagine.
I believe only the pirate can.
Oh.
It's really weird. It's one of those triggers.
Yeah, that's not good. That's not cool. Can't get up there yet, unfortunately. Do we have space jump already?
Yeah, we have.
Yeah, we do. Okay.
Well, if we're going off of the way they want you to get stuff, it's right after you get boost ball.
Okay. Damn super missiles, though.
They're so great.
They are so great. They're so beautiful. So beautiful, it's true. Also destructive. And that's fun. A little bit. It's a little bit fun. To break things.
Yeah.
Are you gonna have to flick bomb? Flick?
I don't need to.
Oh.
Maybe I do.
Oh.
Ironically, that's the way the timing works in on the emulator.
Yeah.
But in this, it puts the...
Well, because you place it as it's exploding instead of right before it explodes. But the emulator doesn't... It's too slow to appreciate that.
It goes like a whole 15 frames slower most of the time.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know how to fix that.
Oh, dear. Oh, you're much better at this than I am. I
am oddly focused right now.
Maybe that's because you are trying to show off. Are you trying to show off?
I don't think I am.
Ladies and gentlemen, Zach is trying to show off. Oh, energy tank! That's good stuff.
That's trying to remember how to jump here.
So I had one of my friends try to play Metroid Prime 3, because he's never played any of the Metroid Prime games, and I told him about the different difficulties of Prime 1, 2, and 3, and he seemed to think that 3 would be easiest for him. He was all over the place. Like, he could not point straight to save his character's life. Like, he could not aim straight. And, like, I had to turn off free aim lock-on because he couldn't point where he was locking on. I was like, how? How? It's... But... What? It didn't make sense to me. And so, you know, I kind of gave him shit for it because... Because Metroid is actually one of the easiest first-person games on the... easiest to aim first-person games on the Wii. Like, because you don't have to aim down your sights to be more accurate. You never have to actually snipe because... And you also have a lock-on. I mean, that's ridiculous. That's like mechanics for a third-person game. But... He still couldn't do it. And I was like, how do you play, like, Call of Duty and stuff? And he goes, the Wii sucks. And I said, oh, that's how.
You're one of them.
One of those people. Elitists who say that the Wii is an inferior gaming platform. Even though, I mean, let's be honest here, it has some pretty fantastic mechanics, even though it's... How old is it?
I got it when I was really young, and I don't remember when that was.
Like, I want to say 9 years old? 10?
I want to say it was, well...
Prime 3 came out in, like, when?
I want to say, like, 2008, but that could be wrong.
Yeah, so...
It was when I was in middle school.
Yeah.
Which, 2008, I think, was my 8th grade.
Minus, by
that's
the way.
Right. Yeah, I keep forgetting.
Hey!
I've been playing too much of the GameCube.
That's okay. I forgive you. Oh dear. Those pirates want you. They want you bad. So, there's actually... I like this. In Prime 3, there's actually only one visor. Like, one extra visor. And it's the X-ray slash thermal. It works like both of them put together.
I forgot about that.
I love it. It's so great.
I love the visors in the second game.
I don't remember what they do.
Dark and Echo.
Oh, right. Echo allows you to point Annihilator Beam at things.
That's... I guess...
It's okay. That's what it is. The thermal visor lets you point plasma beam at things. That's what it does. Oh, look, Metroids! I wasn't expecting that! Oh, no!
I can just press plus. I need to get used to this again.
The controls.
It was a bad idea trying to train for this by playing the GameCube game.
Yep. That is a true statement.
So. I know where everything is, but I don't know how to play it.
That is a thing. I have also been training for Prime 3. I got 100% completion, and we are going to play it on Veteran Mode, which is actually easier than Veteran Mode in Prime 1, oddly enough. Which is probably why I could do it when I was a kid.
One of these times during my live stream, I need to play Hard Mode.
Just anything?
Hard Mode.
Hard Mode!
Something that's not Smite.
Yeah. Smite's hard mode on its own.
I liked Smite, and I didn't think it was that hard.
Aw, that Metroid, though. It was hungry. I remember one of the first feelings I ever got from when I first encountered Metroids. Because Prime was the first game I played. Prime 3, specifically, was the first Metroid game I played.
I don't remember how the Metroids were in Prime. It's been way too long.
Huh? You don't... Wait, what?
I don't remember how the Metroids were in Prime
3.
Sorry.
They're about the same, but I'll let the viewers wait and see, or just look up another playthrough, because that's typically what I do. I just, like... The first reaction I ever had to a Metroid grabbing me in the face was, "Oh my god, get it off! And I died because I didn't know how to get it off. Like, yeah. I was spamming my beam, but you can't hit a Metroid when it's on your face with your beam. And I didn't realize that Morph Ball would probably save me.
Oh, it's because you... Or what's your Metroid experience outside of the Prime series?
At that point?
Yeah, at that point.
No.
Yeah, because that's how you're supposed to get them off in the side-scrollers.
That's just how you get Metroids off, period.
Yep.
And let's be honest here, the fact that they couldn't animate Samus crawling on her, like, on her belly is why they made the Morph Ball. But think of all the mechanics that Metroid just would not be the same without if they had not made Morph Ball. You know?
Even the speedrun aspect of
Morph Ball jumps. Exactly. Yeah, it's like... It instantly becomes a different game, like entirely different. Metroids, you, as soon as a Metroid latched onto your face, you'd be dead. Just end of story.
GG.
And like, I mean, I can't imagine it without Morph Ball. And I actually watched a video where they were talking about how Morph Ball is the stupidest upgrade in all of gaming, and I'm like, I strongly disagree with that. I think it's an awesome upgrade.
I believe it's an awesome upgrade, even if it's just an enabler for better upgrades.
That's true. I may have taken it slightly out of context. Maybe he meant that the fact that you have to get the upgrade in order to shift into Morph Ball form seems redundant. Because if you look at it, like, he did the math, and if you look at it, Samus could just curl up in a ball and be fine. Like, that's literally what she does for Morph Ball.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. My voice already hurts.
Already?
Yeah, already.
Do you yell constantly?
No.
I solved that problem by talking really quiet and really deep.
Really?
Well, I talk way deeper after I've woken up or before I've gone to sleep, like when I'm really tired.
You're just like, oh my god.
I go down about an octave.
I'm so tired. You're just like, oh dude. I'm so tired. Oh.
Shameless promotion of your Twitch channel. just huge, huge annotation. Takes up the whole screen right now. That's a link to your Twitch.
Darn it.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
The security drones again. One of the world's worst enemies. They actually make a reappearance in Metroid Prime 3, just like a lot of things. But oddly enough, when they make their reappearance, they're not linked with the space pirates.
Well, if you want to fear a security drone, you should go and play Fusion.
Yeah, that's...
Did you play Fusion?
Yes, I've beaten every Metroid game except Echoes.
Wow, nice.
Because Echoes is just too much what the hell is going on for me.
There's a lot of extra work after, like, more so than Prime 1, after you get the last upgrades and stuff. You still have to get all 9 of the Sky Keys, which that's 3 less than the number of artifacts, but for some reason the artifacts are just easier to find.
Yeah, I guess. Maybe because they give you massive hints. Also, you should let the Metroids out and have them attack the space pirates.
I don't want to.
Really?
As awesome as it is, I don't want to.
Oh. I think it's interesting because they're completely indiscriminate, and it's been proven. Metroids are smart. Like, they're intelligent creatures that can escape their... That, like, can recognize when they're able to escape something and then figure out a way to. You know? But, and yet they still indiscriminately attack. Even though their torturers, their captors, are sitting right there, they will latch onto your face instead of the pirates. Like, oh, there it goes.
Yep, I don't remember where the door is for some reason. There it is.
It was right behind you the whole time.
Yep, it was. And I'm
surprise! oh, that's right. Those guys also make a reappearance in Metroid Prime 3.
They're in Prime 2. They're not quite as... Wiggly.
Annoying?
Well, they are pretty annoying, but...
Are they as easy to kill?
Kind of. Depends on if you're using Dark Beam or not.
I see. Well, in Prime 3, there's only one way to kill them.
In Prime 2 and Prime 1, there's only one way to kill them.
I know, but in Prime 3, it's annoyingly difficult. And that makes it all the worse. Look! A thing that you can break with a super missile!
Yep. If I can remember what button... shifts me to...
Pew! And now...
Yep.
That.
You don't actually have to be in that to...
Yeah, I know. But...
If you know where they are.
Boop!
I'm letting pretty much everybody know, because I'm going to end up doing that.
All the time, you're just going to be like, I know where this is! Yeah. Don't have to use thermal visor. Oh, are we going to fight Thardis now?
We are right on the path to Thardis.
Oh, I love Thardis!
Thardis is one of my favorite bosses.
Ah, he's difficult.
He just looks cool.
Yeah, he's a giant pile of rocks.
Yep.
I like rocks. Hold on, wait. Next time, we fight Thardis.
Oh my god, you are a teaser.
Yes!